We need to talk about soil, plant, and water relationships. How to apply the right amount of water at the right time for optimum plant growth and quality of the crop. And I think today, we'll start talking about soil, since soil is the basic medium in which most vascular plants grow. As we look at soil, soils have a profile that develops depending on the different situation that the soil develops in. And our plants grow in those soils, and we have to understand that soil profile so that we know how our plant roots act, how deep they go, how much water that soil holds, etc., so that we can then program in the amount of water and the types of crops that might be adapted in those types of things. Now, soils are made up, at least the what we would call the mineral fraction of the soil is made up of three particles, sand, silt, and clay. And we use a textural triangle to define the texture of soils depending on the amount of sand, silt, and clay. And depending on that mixture, it might be a loam soil, or it might be a sandy loam, or a sand, or a silt, or a silty clay loam. And of course, the texture of the soil has a great effect on the amount of water that the soil holds and how plant roots penetrate through the soil to be able to get water and nutrients. So the soil texture is extremely important to us. It's also important because it also affects rapidity of the intake rate of the soil at the surface when we irrigate, and also the permeability as the water moves through the soil. Now, besides the soil texture, soils can also have different structure. And even though a soil might be a silty clay loam, which is a fairly fine textured soil, and you'd think that maybe that it doesn't have a very fast intake rate, if it has good aggregates, it can act almost like a sand soil, a sandy loam, in the way that water moves through the soil and air and so forth, but yet have a good water holding capacity, whereas the sand would not. However, if we have platy structure, even if it's got a sandy loam, if we have platy structure, we can have slow intake rate and slow permeability through the profile, or massive structure. Many times our tillage creates massive structure and causes problems with intake and with infiltration and permeability through the soil profile. So the soil structure is important to us also. So soils are important because they hold the water and the nutrients that the plants use. And we have to understand the texture and the structure of the soil and the chemical makeup of the soil so we know what kind of plants might be adapted and the amount of water and nutrients that are available to the plant. Now, every plant, let's talk about plants now as we talk about soil-plant-water relationships. Here's a little illustration. We all know intuitively that different plants have different rooting zones. We know that, for instance, alfalfa can have an extremely deep root. It has a big, strong tap root that can go very, very deep. However, our lawn grasses over here have a quite short root zone. And a carrot or something like that's not going to have a very deep root zone. Corn and grain have kind of an intermediate root zone. Now, that's important because those plants can only get water and nutrients from the soil where the roots are. They cannot get the water anywhere else. Sometimes we make the mistake that we can put on a whole bunch of water and the soil will save it there. No, that extra water just percolates down through past the root zone, and it is physically impossible for those roots to get that water once it goes past the root zone. So we have to be very conscious about the rooting depth, the root zone of the plants that we're irrigating, and only put on the water that they need in their root zone.